you do if I told you God is waiting on you to act on the earth? Would you believe me? What if I told you God is not going to do anything until he sees you move first? Would you still believe me? What if I told you that we are sovereign over the earth? Would you believe me then? Hi, my name is Adrian Hines, pastor of Kingdom Connections Embassy. And before I talk to you about God is waiting on you, I want to share with you a little bit about my background. I grew up in the church all my life, pretty much. My mom and dad were ministers, and I grew up in a religious environment, nothing that was harsh or anything like that. But I grew up in the church. We were at church pretty much three times out of the week. Most of our friends were from church. And we had a bunch of fun. It's nothing that I hated. We had a bunch of fun. I enjoyed my life growing up as a kid. But I didn't realize, though, that growing up in a church, I knew about Jesus. I knew I had perfect attendance at Sunday school. I knew, was taught how to speak in tongues and all that stuff. But I didn't realize that I didn't have the relationship with Jesus until 2002. And that's actually when I decided to give my life over to Christ. And I'll tell you more about that in another video. But I gave my life over to Christ, but I was still a religious person. And I really didn't get free until I actually, in 2005, when I learned about the kingdom of God, when I learned about the kingdom of heaven. And I learned about the kingdom of heaven through a person by the name of Dr. Miles Monroe. And that's when I became free. And like the scripture says, who the Son sets free is free indeed. I liken my story to the parable in Matthew 13:44, where it says, again, the kingdom of heaven is like treasure hidden in a field where a man found and hid it. And for joy over it, he goes and sells all that he has and buys that field. And so basically, when I found out about the kingdom of heaven, I basically gave up every religious thought, every religious idea, and I became solely focused on how I can obtain the kingdom, how I can pursue righteousness, how I can pursue the kingdom. So that's a little bit about my story. I didn't mean to ramble on, but I get excited when I talk about my transformation. Going back to the question that I posed at the beginning, what if I told you that God is not going to move on the earth until you move first? What if I told you that you are sovereign over the earth? Would you believe me? You know, it bothers me. The reason why it bothers me is because I believe that the body of Christ should be so much further, should have so much more of an impact than we actually do in the earth. And the reason why we don't have the impact is because we are so much into religion. We're so much into tradition. Now, not all tradition is bad, but we're so much into religion and so much into ourselves. And we don't read, and I say we, I'm just generalizing, of course. Most of the body of Christ does not read the word every day. And my question is, how are you going to be a student of the word? How are you going to call yourself a Christian, Christ-like, if you're not studying what he did, if you're not living a life that he did? And I'm not saying this message to condemn, because I was in your shoes before. I didn't read the word like I was supposed to. I didn't live by it, but I knew how to quote scripture. And what bothers me is that, again, the impact that we're supposed to have on the world, we're not experiencing because people are ignorant of the word of God. And most importantly, people are ignorant of the most important message of the Bible, that the whole Bible really is focused around. And I may say some controversial things, but I challenge you, if you read the word of God and study it, you will see that what I am saying is correct. I'm not speaking some new age stuff. I'm not starting a cult or anything like that. But what I am speaking is truth in the word of God. This is not my opinion or anything like that. I just challenge you to read the scriptures for yourself. We're talking about things that we're not talking about, and we're not studying and understanding. Most of the body of Christ has no clue what the kingdom of God is, what the kingdom of heaven is. And it is my firm belief that because we are ignorant as a whole of the message behind Jesus Christ, of the message behind the Bible, of the message that God came to us, that Jesus came to establish here on earth, because we are ignorant of that, then we stay praying, we stay begging God, we stay crying to God. I'm going to say something that may shock you. God does not respond to our tears. God does not respond to our needs as we think he does. As a matter of fact, let me share this with you. God is waiting on you. Essentially, God is waiting on you to move. God is waiting on you to use your faith before he starts to move on earth. And let me preface this by saying, I'm going to back everything up with scripture. Please believe. In Genesis 1:26, God gave mankind their first mandate. He was speaking amongst Jesus, him, and the Holy Spirit. He said, let us make man in our image and let them have dominion over the earth, over the fish of the sea, the birds in the air, and every creeping thing that crawls upon the earth. That word dominion means authority, kingship. It talks about leadership, dominating the earth, not dominating each other, but dominating the earth. So in essence, what God was doing, he was pretty much saying, I am not going to move on earth without a spirit. I'm not going to move on earth without mankind. I'm not going to move on earth illegally without me working through mankind. And God was giving us sovereignty over the earth. Of course, we must go to him to get our leadership, and we must go to him to get direction. But God has created us to be sovereign over earth. Now, what a lot of people are doing in the body of Christ, they're waiting on God. They're praying to God. They're crying out to God. Tears are rolling down their face, and God does not respond to that. God responds only to his word. Watch what I say. Moses. Moses, when he was leading the people out of Egypt, millions of Israelites were following him. They came to the Red Sea. Moses looked up to God and looked at God and said, God, what are you going to do? This is me paraphrasing. This is how I take it. And God said, what are you standing there for? What's that in your hand? And Moses had the staff, and he said, spread your arms out, speak to the water, and it parted. So Moses spoke what God told him to do. Look at Ezekiel. Ezekiel in the valley of the dry bones. God told Ezekiel to prophesy to the bones. And when Ezekiel took his faith and began to open his mouth and agree with what the word of God says, life came into those bones. A perfect example is, look at Jesus Christ. Jesus never waited on God to act. Why? Because he was always in communion with the Father. He was always in connection with him. Jesus said, you see me do what you see my Father in heaven do. Basically, I'm doing what my Father in heaven does. And so Jesus knew that in order for things to change here on earth, not only did he have to speak the word, but he had to make sure that his mind was in tune with the word of God, since he was the word incarnate. And he had to make sure that he lived it out. Jesus never waited on God. And that's why the kingdom manifested itself when Jesus was here on earth. If you look at the life of Peter and Paul, Peter after the resurrection or after the ascension of Jesus, these men represented the kingdom of God here on earth because they knew that they were supposed to act. They knew that they were supposed to agree with God's word on situations that were happening in life and then act on it. And that's all God is looking for us to do. Jesus said, if you have faith the size of a mustard seed, and what that faith is you believing God at his word, and then you agreeing with God's word, whatever situation you're facing, you agree with God on his word, and then you move on what his word says. That's all it is. And that's that. God is only looking for us to take a step. He's not looking for us to complete the whole thing, because as long as we take that initial step, like Peter did when he stepped out of the boat, when he saw Jesus walking on water, Peter stepped out of the boat and took that step. That's all God is looking for us to do, is to initially take that step, because in order to operate in his kingdom, you must operate by faith. And that's all it is. It's all about faith. You must operate by faith. And so I challenge you to read the word of God. Find out whatever situation you're facing. If you're facing a lack right now in finances, if you're facing debt right now, I challenge you to read the word of God. Find out what his word says about lack and about debt and about money. And then you speak that word over your life. Not only do you do that, I'm not one of those people that just speak faith, but you have to have actions too. You have to have practicality. So not only do you speak the word of God over your life, but you make sure that you take the steps to where you stop overspending, you come up with the budget, you make sure you pay off your creditors, and you take those steps, and then watch how God moves miraculously in your life, but it's not really miraculously. You're just applying kingdom principles. That's really all it is. I'm giving you, Jesus has already given us the keys of the kingdom. And so I just want to help you to understand that whatever the keys of the kingdom are meant to unlock whatever you need, that the storehouse is in heaven. We have an unlimited amount of resources in heaven. We just have to learn how to tap into it so that we can use it in the natural realm. I mean, it operates in the spirit realm first, and then it manifests in the natural. And so I'm really excited about helping believers to understand more about God's kingdom, because it is my firm belief that when people fully understand their identity in Christ, understand that they are kings and daughters of the Most High God, understand that the principles on how God's kingdom operates, I really believe that we will be able to change the world. We'll have so much of a more powerful, positive impact on the world. And I go off of this promise that Jesus gave his disciples. He said, whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. Whatever you loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven. And the very gates of hell will not prevail against my church. That's the promise that Jesus, that's one of the promises that he gives us. He gives us another promise that he has given us power and authority over the enemy. So we are always victorious. We always, God always causes us to triumph through Jesus Christ. But we have to act on his word. We have to speak his word. We have to really believe that we are kings here on earth over the domain, over the authority that God has given us. And we have to speak that thing and then act on it and then watch God move. I guarantee you it will happen. But God is waiting on you. He does. I don't want this video to go longer than what it is, but that's what I really wanted to share with you, to share with the body of Christ. God is really waiting on you to act here on earth. He's given us sovereign authority over the earth to act on his behalf. That's how much he loves us. That's how much he believes in us. That's how much God just loves us so much that he has given us the responsibility to change the world. And so I challenge you, go out. Read the word of God, apply it to your life, and then whatever action steps you need to take, take it. Watch God move. To get more information about Kingdom Connections Embassy, we will be officially launching January 8th, 2012. Make sure you go to our Facebook fan page, facebook.com/Kingdom Connections, and Connections is spelled with a K. Thank you for taking the time to watch this video. If it was able to bless you, encourage you, inspire you, make sure you leave a comment. I want to interact with you. And also make sure you share it with your friends on Facebook and Twitter as well. So again, thank you for taking the time to watch the video. And I'm going to end it like this, like I do most of my videos. If you do the word of God, if you follow the word of God, you will be blessed. Take care.